Police arrived at the two-story home in March. Urgent confusion clouded the crime scene. Neighbors said Elaine Simons had just rung their doorbell telling a horrific story.
The doorbell rang. I went to the door. She was slumped over like this, bleeding all over. I said, I got stabbed.
They said Simons' 13-year-old son, Dane, came stumbling into their backyard, also covered in blood, stabbed more than two dozen times. Snipers set up outside the house, and then Simons' oldest son, 15-year-old Kyle, came outside shirtless and confused. Police weren't sure how many people might be dead, how many people might be responsible.
Bodies in the house as well as suspects in the house, both.
Eventually, police figured out there was one body in the house, 13-year-old Giovanni Sierra, stabbed to death in the upstairs loft. And downstairs, hiding in the study, the suspected killer, 17-year-old Corey Johnson.
Is he holding the knife?
Yeah, he has a knife in his hand.
He just closed the door.
His best friend Kyle was still confused about what he'd glimpsed on the loft as he stumbled out of his bedroom, thinking it was his brother lying on the floor.
I went to the loft and I saw my brother on the floor and I saw a bunch of blood marks or stain marks of blood around it. I'm like, what the heck?
The dawning daylight revealing the awful trail of blood throughout the house leading to Giovanni's body one day after his birthday.
Police say Johnson was influenced by violent jihadist videos, and he told them Giovanni was making fun of his newfound Islamic beliefs. He awaits trial on murder and attempted murder charges.